Yo, what's up? Let's be real, we have all been there. We've created the perfect Power BI report, we published it up to the service, and then boom, our inbox goes crazy with questions like, where is this report? How do I get access? You did some updates, but I can't see them. I'm here to tell you there's a better way to scale your distribution of Power BI reports than the traditional workspace apps. Now, if you're managing multiple Power BI reports, real-time dashboards, notebooks, or paginator reports, with org apps, you can bundle these items together in a branded, beautiful package and share it with your entire organization or specific people. And the best part is you can have multiple org apps on top of one workspace. Yay! And the org app also updates automatically. But how do you create an org app? Well, you know what? Enough of all this talking. You know what we like to do here at GuyNeCube. Let's head over to my laptop. Now I'm inside my Power BI workspace and we have a bunch of notebooks here. We have a bunch of reports. And I know that I have different type of people that want access to these different types of things. And I need to find a way to share that. And I'm gonna use org apps to do it. Now, the very first thing you have to do when you're inside of Fabric is to go to settings in the admin portal and you need to enable org apps for your tenant. So you do that by searching here, you find it, and you need to make sure that this one is enabled for the entire organization or specific security groups. Now let's head back to my workspace and let's click new item. You see here in the visualize, we have org app in preview as an option. So I'm going to click that one. Now I want to create an org app that I'm going to share with Justin Case. And I know Justin is really interested in knowing how many comments are we getting on the videos because he wants to see if we're actually answering them. And he also wants to better understand the logic that we have inside of the notebooks. So I'm going to call this org app YouTube or GuyNeCube YouTube controller because Justin is kind of our controller. He's going to control stuff. Now this is what your canvas looks like. So let's add some content to this org app. Let's start by clicking add content. And now you see all the items that I can add. And I wanted to add some statistics. I also want to add this compare video report that we have. Let's also add this real-time dashboard. And then I want to add the sentiment analysis notebook for Justin to better understand the logic that we have here. So I'm going to add that to the app. Now we see that we have the Power BI reports as you would have in a normal app. We have the real-time dashboard here. We have the sentiment analysis notebook giving insights on what our code is to create the sentiment analysis and the video search and stats production report as well. Now there's different things we can do here now. We can also decide to section this a bit. So I want to do that. I want to have one section for reports and then I want to have one section for notebooks. And then I'm going to move my reports to the report section. And then my sentiment analysis to the notebook one. Now I also want to add an overview page for Justin to better see what is inside this org app like that. And then I want to have that as the first page of my org app. Now the overview page is going to show the content like this. And here you can do some customization. So I want to add a header and give it a good title. And I also want to apply an app theme that's going to be the background color. So let's click add. You see that we have the beautiful heading, we have the description here, but the background is still gray and that's because you have to do that through customization. Let's customize this a bit and brand it a little bit. Now here you can add an app image and an app theme. So let's start out by adding the GuyNeCube logo and also for the app theme I want to use the GuyNeCube blue color like that. Now under navigation, you can also decide, do you want to have a combined app and report page navigation? Do you want to separate the app and report page navigation? Do you want it to by default be expanded or collapsed? And also, do you want to show the report pages pane? Now I'm going to keep it as is and just hit apply. And now we see that we have the GuyNeCube blue here as part of the overview page. Now let's check out the settings. So if I open up this, you see that you can decide on a sensitivity label. We can endorse it if we want to, and we can also add tags. Now let's preview this app. We have the overview page as the first page. You can open up different reports and also take a look at the different notebooks. Now there is one more thing that we can do, and that is to add a link. Now, and this could be any type of link that is embeddable, but I was thinking, you know what, Justin, he works hard. He needs some fun in his life. So I'm gonna add a YouTube video as a link for him to just enjoy stuff a bit more. add the URL address, and I want it to be embedded into the content of the app. I'm gonna hit create like that. Now I'm happy with this. I'm ready to publish this. I'm gonna click save. And now the next thing we can do is to manage access. Now we can do that by, well, hitting manage access there. We can also click share here, copy the link to this app, the link to this specific app page, or manage access and add a person or group. Now the person I want to share this with is Justin. And see here that I'm not checking this share button, I'm just clicking grant. And if we now go back to the actual workspace and scroll down a little bit, you see here that we have Guiding Cube, YouTube controller, org app as an item here. Now if I check out the permissions, under manage permissions, you see here the people that have access to the workspace itself, they already have read or write or reshare dependent on the workspace role they have. But we also see that Justin, he doesn't have a workspace role, but he does have read access to the org app. Now I can change this and also add reshare here directly, or if I choose the share button, add Justin and mark that share button, you're gonna see Justin also has reshare access. So that means that he can then reshare the org app to other people, maybe someone in his team. Now let's check out what this looks like for Justin. So here I have logged in as Justin Case, and if I go into apps now, we're gonna see that Justin have the Guiding Cube YouTube controller app already installed by default. He didn't have to go into get apps and install it to get it. And if I open that one up, we see that Justin can now take a look at the different reports. Just as we expected, he can also take a look at the notebook. And the best part, Justin can also have some fun. It was a late night in front of a bright Power BI moon. Pat LeBlanc was in the lab going live soon. Now I'm curious to know if you have already used org apps, because they have been out for a little while. If you haven't, let me know if you're gonna check them out. What's your best use cases for org apps? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, remember to check out our Guiding Cube courses, check out the other awesome videos, and subscribe so we can see you guys in the next video. Bye!